take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back in the shop. We got something quite a bit different here today. We're moving everything that's mine and taking it to another shop. This is kind of a little bit unexpected, but not really. As I mentioned previous, some of my other videos, the whole place got bought out by a different owner, and things changed, and I kind of had a bad gut feeling about it from the start. And not to drag it out, I'm not going to mention anything too detailed on here for now, but to make a long story short, a lot of different changes, and they kind of pushed me out, and kind of really ticked me off, and weighed my hand, put in my 2 weeks. As much as I didn't want to, I just wanted to up and leave, but tried to be a little bit respectful about it and put in my 2 weeks, and lined up another job, and here we are 2 weeks later, moving day, and we gotta try to get this whole thing loaded onto my car hauler trailer. I got my overhead creeper back there. I got, what else we got? I got my welding table slash work table. I got fridge down there, microwave, and I got that little cart. We gotta load all of that onto my car hauler trailer, and a lot of weight. I'm not sure how this is gonna go quite. I think we'll do all right. I got a couple outriggers that I made from my toolbox to keep it from flipping, and I showed those in a previous video as well. You're welcome to see how I put those together. But I'll show y'all how I put all this together and my plan on how I'm gonna load this. And I think it's gonna go all right. Kinda sucks today. It's kinda nasty weather out there, drizzly, rainy. I have a tarp I'm gonna try to wrap this in and keep as much water as I can off it, and we'll see how it goes. So I'm gonna pull my truck in here and get to it. So I had to speed up several sections of the video, just so it's not 2 hours long. And what I'm doing here is I'm strapping a strap across the top, goes through the eyelets on the top of each outrigger, running a strap on the bottom, just to hold those tight to the box. And I'm just gonna jump up here and tighten that one up a little more. And
thank you.
All right, we got it all loaded up here. Had just a little bit trouble getting over the peak of the dovetail right there. I have about 2.5 inches of clearance, and it drugged there and kind of pulled my outriggers back a little bit, but not too bad. We made it over. Cleaned out the whole entire wall over there, more or less. Got all my stuff back here. Creeper stool. One other issue, small issue we had. Let's see where I got my cable hooked right here. This whole part that bolts to the toolbox, there's bolts that go through here, and this started pulling off the box a little bit, and this the corner here isn't strong enough, so I put this come along with this chain. It kind of holds it tight, and would have never had the issue, but I basically used that cable there to pull the whole entire weight, and just a bit much for it. A little bit of engineering defect, I guess. But we're all on there and ready to roll. We'll get to the next shop and see what we can do about getting this unloaded. All right, we made it here to the next shop. Luckily, it wasn't too far. Only about 5 miles down the road, so just took it slow, and I had it strapped down there pretty good. I've already taken off some of the straps, but we'll see what it takes to get it off here and see what happens. So I got all the straps stripped off, and I'm just kind of inching it forward using the drive on the actual toolbox as an assist to roll it on the flat surface, because gravity's not going to help me here. And you can see me messing with my winch over there. Go figure, my winch works perfectly fine for 1.5 years, and when I go to unload my box, it gives me trouble. But that's how that stuff always goes. Just kind of inching it back here. I put these boards on either side just in case it started tipping. It couldn't tip very far. The outriggers would keep it upright. Now here I'm adding this piece of metal as a way to raise the end of it as it comes over the dovetail. Because as I mentioned previous, I had trouble. It hung up on the outriggers, and I'm trying to avoid that here. So I put that piece of metal on top of that board and just see how it kind of lumps up over top of it. A little bit of trouble here trying to get it to go over top of that, and in the edge of the metal popped up as the wheels went over top of the board and it hung up under there. I'm just trying to pry it down and get it over, and slowly inching it off. One of the truck drivers came in and he's helping me
give it a little boost as it kind of hangs up still on the dovetail. But it's going pretty well, all things considered. Slowly just trying to inch it off there. Now I'm trying to get that piece of board out because it's hanging up on the bottom of the box and giving me trouble. And as you can see, it's kind of stuck in there. I'll get it out here in a minute once it kind of overcomes the dovetail a little bit. But, and I don't want to pull that plate of metal out because that plate of metal is so I can get over the gap. It's about a 3-inch gap between the where the ramps fold up there on the end of the trailer. And I don't want to drop a wheel in that and possibly flip the box or who knows what. It'll definitely get stuck and the box is so heavy I don't want to try to have to get it out of that once it falls in there. So we're just going to keep that plate of metal on there like that. Just slowly coming off. There it went, finally. This is where I get some trouble. You see it tip like that.
It'll be okay.
The corner of the where the diamond plate is, the L-shaped pieces on the front of the box, hits, because the incline is too great, it hits on the corner of the concrete, causing an issue there. And I have to jack it up and put little blocks of wood under the wheels on the bottom just to get it so the wheels will actually roll so it doesn't gouge the concrete and we can actually get it slid off of here. And that's my boss right there, one of the truck drivers, and me all just trying to jack it up and get those blocks under there using a heavy-duty scissor jack because that's all that'll fit the low profile. There you go, we finally got it up and we're just inching it off a little bit at a time. And there it kind of dropped off one of the blocks, kind of tipped a little bit, but nothing concerning. And my winch keeps giving me trouble through this. I cut some of the video out where I was messing with it trying to get it working. But it's a little more than I planned on as far as how hard it would be to get off of there. But all considering, it's going pretty well. We keep having to shim the wheels just to keep them up high enough so that corner doesn't gouge the concrete. And then just slowly inch it off here a little bit at a time so it doesn't go too quick. Having more trouble with my winch there. I'm going to have to warranty the remote for it. And it's about ready to come off. It's getting close. Once it gets to that certain point, it's gonna roll right down. You can see that piece of 1/8-inch steel I got over the gaps on the ramps just to keep the wheels out of them, especially my drive wheels because they're close together in the center. But I thought about going and weighing it on a scale. And I should have. Now that I got it off, it'll never get weighed. I'm curious how much it does actually weigh. I'm sure it's gotta be 3,000 or 4,000 pounds. But, getting real close and just fell off the end of the ramps.
You ought to be free of the bird now.
Yeah, I like it. There you go.
Damn, wait.
As always, thank y'all for watching. And if you appreciate this type of content and what I've got going on here, I'd appreciate it if you'd hit that follow button, that subscribe button, whether you're on Facebook or YouTube, and hit that thumbs up. It's always appreciated. It helps me out because they can get me out there and I can get more available to the crowd that I want to draw, and it helps you out because you won't miss out on any of the great content that I'm producing here. And if you don't like it, I'd rather you just not say anything or put a comment in the comment section and let others know why you don't like it, but please nothing vulgar or anything like that. And I started this channel because this is the type of videos I like to watch on YouTube and Facebook, and this is what I want to produce so other people can watch it. So if you like it, you know what to do. And I appreciate you watching all the way through, and until next time.